name is Emily Crawford, and I'm a postdoc in Joe DeRisi's lab at UCSF, and we're here in the lab right now. So I'm doing basic research on the parasite that causes malaria. So it's a parasite called Plasmodium, and we're working on different ways of how to genetically engineer the parasite so that we can better study how it actually operates, how it causes disease, and also how it can become resistant to drugs that are used around the world to treat malaria, so that we can prevent that from happening in the future. I grew up actually in Cambridge, Massachusetts, which was a fun place to grow up. Neither of my parents are research scientists, but my mother is a psychologist, my father is a software engineer. And I actually became interested in biology after my ninth grade biology class. It was just incredibly exciting. This would have been 1999, so there was just so much interesting stuff going on in biology then. The human genome sequencing project was going on, and I was just really amazed at all the different things that were out there to study in biology. And ever since then, I've known that this is what I want to do for my career. It's really amazing all the stuff that we can do when we can actually manipulate the genes of an organism like Plasmodium, like the malaria parasite. Even 10 or 20 years ago, there were all these only very roundabout ways to answer questions like, how does malaria acquire drug resistance? Now that we're starting to be able to do it in a much more direct manner, it's incredibly exciting. We can, you know, do a few days worth of experiments and have sequencing data that, you know, we can then spend the next several weeks going through and, learning all these incredibly fine details about the biology of the parasite and drug resistance.
So this is the FPLC instrument, and we use it for purifying proteins. We're going to take our protein in a small volume in a syringe like this and actually load it into the system. The solution then actually pushes the protein through the entire system, so it goes from the injection valve.
I'm lucky in that the project I'm working on right now has a lot of different aspects to it. So I'm not stuck doing the exact same thing every single day. I'm probably working at the bench, you know, two-thirds of the time, and the computer the rest, and a lot of it is meeting with people as well and talking through things and diagramming things out on the whiteboard or on paper, that kind of thing. We have a tissue culture room where essentially the parasites are cultured in human blood. The malaria parasite infects the red blood cells, and we're able to have it survive in culture over long periods of time. It's not a risk to humans when it's in that condition in the tissue culture room. It's able to do is survive in the red blood cell. It can't go anywhere from there to infect you, so it's not terribly dangerous to work with. And then there are other days where that's sort of, you've gotten past that stage, and you get to the really fun stuff, in my opinion, which is the data analysis. So, for example, just earlier we were looking at some sequencing data, and that was essentially we were looking at sequences of many copies of the same gene to see if and how we had successfully made a mutation in that gene. That was sort of the goal of this research project. So that's the really exciting part, is where you get to sit on your computer and look at the data that you've generated and actually create a meaning out of it. And then, of course, simultaneously, you have to not just understand that meaning yourself, but come up with how you're going to convey that to the rest of the scientific community. So how are you going to design figures for your paper, or design the text of your paper to show that this is what you did, and convince everybody that that your conclusions are correct. So you're here on a good day, because I'm really happy and proud of the results I've just gotten from this malaria genome editing project. I'm looking forward to kind of finishing up that story and getting it into a publication. It's been a lot of hard work by me and a couple of other people in the lab for the past 6 months or so. I think what's really fascinating and attractive about biomedical research right now is the potential is just virtually infinite. The number of questions that we can ask now and that we can answer with things like genome sequencing and proteomics is just so vast that there's so much more to be done than any one scientist can do in a lifetime. So there's you can never be bored. You can never run out of fascinating questions that are important to answer. And you're sort of in this rich intellectual area where you can pick and choose what's interesting to you and just go for it. That's what I like about doing this.